In this video, you'll learn what loop is, how to build a loop, and how to distinguish between different types of loop nodes in KNIME Analytics Platform. Let's jump into it. Imagine the following use case. You have a list of orders from different countries, and you want to write the orders for each country into a separate sheet, in this example, an Excel sheet. What you can do, of course, is to check which countries are there in the table. Select the first one, filter its orders, write it to a separate sheet, and then repeat the process for the next country until you go through all of them. This can be a tedious and error-prone process. What if the number of countries is large? Or what if new countries appear in the orders from time to time? Is there a simpler way? Yes, you can repeat the workflow segment for different data by using a loop. You can also define the parameters for parts of this workflow segment that should dynamically change depending on the iteration with flow variables. So let's see what a loop is. A loop can iterate over a workflow segment and repeat its execution automatically for different inputs. What changes for each iteration can be a parameter value, a data set, a subgroup of the same data set, a single column, or a single row as flow variables. A loop in KNIME begins with a loop start node, contains the loop body, and ends with a loop end node. Generally, the loop start node increases the iteration counter and sends the data to the loop body. The loop body then executes the operations to be repeated. After those are performed, the loop end node checks if the end condition is fulfilled, and if not, the loop start node starts the next iteration, and the loop body performs the operations again. When the end condition is fulfilled, the loop end node collects the data from the different iterations and closes the loop. Let's look at a simple example of a loop that can solve the task discussed earlier, namely to filter the orders for each country and write them to a separate sheet. The group loop start node here defines the column categories the loop iterates through. At each new iteration, it filters the data for one category and sends it to the loop body. It also exports a flow variable describing which category is used in this iteration. In the loop body, we have only one node, the Excel writer, which at each iteration writes the order data from the country to a separate sheet. This node will name each sheet according to the corresponding country because it's parameterized by the category flow variable from the group loop start node. The loop body can, of course, be as complex as you need, with multiple nodes, more advanced workflow structures, and even nested loops. Finally, the variable loop end node checks whether the loop iterated through all the countries, and if yes, closes the loop and collects flow variables from all the iterations. The loop you saw now is just one of many types of loops available in KNIME Analytics platform. For different types of loops, there are different loop start and loop end nodes. For example, a group loop start you saw in the example iterates over groups of data until it iterates through all of them. A similar node is a chunk loop start. It does the same for consecutive data chunks of a specified size. These two nodes are useful when in each loop iteration you need to process a different group of data. Another common node is a counting loop start node that performs a specified number of iterations. This node is useful when you know beforehand how many times the loop should execute. A different type of loop is a recursive loop. A recursive loop start node iterates over the loop body output data table until a particular condition is met. This loop is useful, for example, when you need to retry some action until success. Let's have a look at a couple of examples of loop end nodes. The most common way to close a loop is with a loop end node. It concatenates the data from iterations. A loop end column append does the same but column-wise by joining the tables from different iterations. A variable loop end node that you saw in the example provides a way to close the loop that doesn't produce any data. For example, when all the data processing ends and the data gets exported in the loop body. You can see that there are many other loop start and end nodes available in KNIME Analytics platform. While some loop start nodes can be paired only with one type of loop end node, some loop start nodes have several options with which loop end node to be combined. In this video, you have learned what a loop is, how to build a loop, and how to distinguish between different types of loop nodes available in KNIME Analytics platform.